everybody gets this, everybody ponders this question, you get asked this question, who's the best? Is it the SEALs, is it the Rangers, is it Delta? Who's the best, right? Well, so here's the deal, and everybody answers the same way. Well, they all have different missions. Green Beret or UW, and CAG is unilateral strike, and SEALs do maritime ops. That's great, everybody's got different missions, but nowadays, the missions kind of blend in together. So here's my answer to that question. It depends on the man. It comes down to the man. I've met SEALs who are awesome. I've met Green Berets who are awesome. I've met Delta guys who are awesome, really good, really proficient. But I've met a bunch who suck, absolutely suck. And it's like Heraclitus said. And honestly, I think the breakdown is the same. So Heraclitus says that out of 100 men, you know, 80 of them, out of 100 fighters, 80 of them, they're useless. And then you got 10, we're lucky to have them. 9 of them, they make the fight. And then there's one, he's a warrior, and he'll bring the others back. And that's pretty true. That's true to life, right? So I would say the most majority of guys in special operations, they suck. They suck because once they get that Green Beret tried, and once they pass their OTCs or whatever it is, or whatever gate they have to pass to get the magic dust sprinkled on them, so to speak, they end up just not continuing to excel as a professional soldier or warrior, whatever it is when you want to call it, because they have what they want, right? They've reached their goal, and it's like a feather in their cap. And then whenever they're at a dinner party, they'll always talk about that. I was a this, I was that. Great. So that's the first type of guy, right? You've got those guys who the unit makes them. You know, the unit bestows upon them a certain level of eliteness, of you know, it's pseudo-eliteness, because eliteness is just, it's perception, right? You got the second guy who's more like the 20%. That's the 80%. You got the 20% in there, right? The 20% of the guys who, those are the guys who day in and day out, man, they try. Whether they start out and they suck, they just keep getting better and better through the years, through the decades. They keep going to war, getting better at war, getting better at their tactics. They get up every day and they, you know, they take their shooting seriously. They're incredibly competitive. They stay in shape, in tremendous shape, despite the fact that they get injured or despite the fact that they have kids or whatever. Those are the 20% of the guys, right? And then you got the 9 who are just even that much better. And then you got the 1%, and that's the warrior, right? And he's like the guy... He's like Achilles, man. That's the dude who everybody aspire, that 20%, that's the guy who they aspire to be. And I think a lot of the guys, a lot of the dudes who aspire to be that warrior, whether you're a SEAL, Green Beret, Delta, whatever, you will eventually make that as long as you stay in long enough, because that takes a long time to get to that level. a lot of guys are really good at fitness. You see this in different communities, right? A lot of guys are really good at fitness. Some guys are really good at shooting. Some guys are really good at tactics. Very few special forces guys are good at all of them. And so the guy who's good at all of them, who's well-rounded, he's that 1%. The guy who's a tremendous leader, because leadership's a skill, right? So you got the big fundamental skills. You got fighting, you got shooting, you got fitness, you got leadership, you got tactics. A warrior is good at all 5 of those. He's not only good at them, but he is... He can teach them. He's done them all. He has exercised those. He strives to improve at all of those things. And believe me, you know, your career, once you get to that level, you probably don't have a lot of time left in your career in the military. So that's kind of my long-winded answer to what community is the best. It depends on the man. I think every community has its strengths and weaknesses. But are there any elite units in the military? I don't know. It's made up. They're made up of men. I mean, what percentage do you have to make something elite? So I don't know. I think if you could cherry pick the best of the best out of everywhere in the military, and not use a subjective model to assess those men, and use a purely objective model in your assessment of those men, you would have a truly elite unit. But we don't have that. There's too much cronyism and nepotism built into selection events or. You know, choosing soldiers, right? Choosing soldiers into these so-called elite units. I think that's where you would have, where like a private army would be very, I think a private army who runs their own selection and process would be far greater than any military unit, simply because they would pick the absolute best. It's like an NBA team. They're going to pay their players the most, and they're going to get the best talent. But anyway, that's my thoughts on it. Yeah, keep watching.